Nerd punch.
We know in games the Master Chief and other Spartans will immediately die if they fall in water.
A memorial to heroes fallen.
In the Halo 2 game's Greymon mission where Chief jumps into water to avoid the Covenant ship's weapon, he does survive. But obviously that's probably because the Greymon captured him. Before his capture, he was definitely sinking and definitely would have drowned. No countermeasures were deployed to ensure his survival. So in the cutscene, he didn't immediately die like he did in the games, but he just didn't float. So, would Master Chief, a super soldier from 500 years in the future that saved the entire human race from alien invasion, die if he found himself unconscious in the deep end of a kiddie pool? Well, first we need to know, how buoyant is Master Chief? Well, let's see how buoyant he is without his armor first. I mean, can he even float without his armor? Most humans do float, but John isn't most humans. John is a 6'7" and 287-pound monster without his armor. Some examples of what Master Chief would look like in terms of size and what we're dealing with is strongman Vincent Urbank or this giant dude. To do that, we need to calculate his buoyancy force, which is what pushes him up in the water, and then the gravity force, which is what pulls him down in the water. The formula for buoyancy force is volume times density of fluid times gravity. The formula for gravity force is the mass of the object times gravity. To find the volume of Chief, so we can use it in the buoyancy formula, we use the formula volume equals mass divided by density. Master Chief weighs 287 pounds, so we convert that to 130,183 grams. Humans have an average density of 1,000 kilograms per cubic meter with 15 to 20% body fat. Considering John is jacked, has a low body fat of, say, 8 to 10%, and reinforced bones and super dense tissues, let's give him a density of 1,100 kilograms per cubic meter. So to find Master Chief's volume, we take 130,183 grams and divide that by 1.1 grams per cubic centimeter to get a total of 118,348 cubic centimeters. So Master Chief has a volume of 4.179 cubic feet with no air in his lungs. And I know you're like, whoa, whoa, hold up. Master Chief would have air in his lungs. That could have a huge effect on his buoyancy. I got it. Normal adult human males have up to 5 or 6 liters of lung capacity for more athletic guys. Again, John ain't no ordinary fella. According to Halo books, at age 14, John has the body of an 18-year-old Olympic athlete due to these augmentations. There is speculation that Michael Phelps has a lung capacity of 12 liters, though this is unsupported. World record freediver Herbert Nitsch has a reported lung capacity of 14 liters. So it isn't too crazy to think that an augmented super soldier could have a lung capacity of double an average human. So let's just give Master Chief a lung capacity of 12 liters. So we take the 4.179 cubic feet with no air in John's lungs plus 12 liters or 0.42 cubic feet of lung capacity with air. So Master Chief has a total volume of 4.59 cubic feet or 0.13 cubic meters of total volume with air in his lungs. So back to our buoyancy force equation. We have 0.13 cubic meters times the density of fluid, which is, for freshwater, 1,000 kilograms per cubic meter at 4 degrees Celsius, times gravity, which is 9.18 meters per second squared. And the force of buoyancy for John with no armor and full lungs is 1,275 newtons. Now we need to find out if the force of gravity for John is greater than the force of buoyancy. If the force of buoyancy is greater than the force of gravity, the object will float. On the other side, if the force of gravity is greater, it will sink. If they're equal, the object is said to be neutrally buoyant. So let's complete this force of gravity equation. We take the mass of the object times gravity. So Master Chief has a mass of 130.18 kilograms times 9.81, and we get a total of 1,277 newtons. So force of buoyancy is 1,275. Force of gravity is 1,277. The conclusion is he will sink. It's not looking good. But if he had a bunch of fizzy soda and had about 2 liters of extra stomach gas, he'd be around 1,294 newtons. So he would float. Basically, Master Chief lives or dies depending on if he drinks some soda. Well, this isn't the end of Master Chief yet. Most of the sea is salt water, and salt water is more buoyant than fresh water. So you repeat the same calculations, but salt water has a density of around 1,029 kilograms per cubic meter, and the end result is a force of buoyancy of 1,312 newtons, and a force of gravity of 1,277 newtons. So in salt water, John will float without drinking any Diet Coke. That's good news, and this might save his life in a hypothetical situation we'll bring up in a bit. For now, John is not so lucky. Master Chief and his armor are basically inseparable, and he will live or die depending on our conclusions of his buoyancy and armor. What we're going to do is add his armor to our previous calculations of him without armor. Master Chief is about 7 feet tall and weighs about 1,000 pounds in his armor. So his armor weighs about 700 pounds separately. Master Chief's armor is composed of some form of titanium alloy. One of the strongest titanium alloys is Ti3Au, which is a titanium gold alloy. This is about 3 to 4 times harder than most steels, and it's 4 times harder than pure titanium. The density of Ti3U is, based on my estimations, to be about 8.21 grams per cubic centimeter. To find the volume of the Spartan 2 armor, we take its mass, divide it by its density, and we come out to 1.365 cubic feet. We know John's volume is 4.59 cubic feet without armor, so we add the Spartan 2 armor, which is 1.365 cubic feet, so the combined volume is 5.95 cubic feet of John in his armor. Now we do the force of buoyancy and force of gravity equations, and we come out with a force of buoyancy of 1,716 newtons and a force of gravity of 4,391 newtons. He's roughly not buoyant at all. This is really bad news because Master Chief can't take his suit off quickly if he's sinking because it's basically bolted on. In the books, Mjolnir armor is removable, but it takes a great deal of training to do so. Initially, the Spartans required an entire team of technicians to put the armor on as well as take it off. As the years progressed and the Spartans got more used to the armor, they were able to take it apart on a smaller scale. But Master Chief removing a shoulder plate isn't gonna really affect him sinking that much. If Master Chief were to fall in deep water, he wouldn't feasibly be able to take enough of it off quickly enough to avoid sinking to the bottom of the ocean. I mean, even if he could take his armor off completely, he still may not be buoyant enough depending on the body of water he fell into and would eventually sink and drown, just a much slower death. So taking his armor off wouldn't necessarily be a helpful thing to do anyways, depending on the situation. Obviously, Dr. Halsey, the creator of the Spartans, wouldn't overlook this sort of fatal design flaw, right? She must have designed something for the suit to combat this. Well, it is a sealed system, so he won't drown right off the bat. That's good. He has integrated thruster packs, but they would not work underwater very well, and they are limited use and cannot be relied upon for long-term buoyancy. They were really designed for use in space and limited maneuvering in normal atmosphere. At the time the Mjolnir project began, Halsey had planned on the Mark 7 suit featuring the following upgrade: limited shaping of the energy shield via partial overlaps or airfoils. The energy shield could be shaped to increase hydrodynamics, but it wouldn't help much as the shaping of the energy field would be quite limited, nor is the drag when moving forward the main issue. The issue is involuntarily moving downwards in a body of water. So no, this wouldn't help at all. It doesn't actually appear that anybody developed the Spartan suits with water survivability in mind. Sorry, Master Chief. But let's just say Dr. Halsey and the Spartan program tasked us with the water survivability of these suits. What could we do with modern technology to keep Spartans from drowning and sinking to their deaths? First off, I'm curious, how fast will Master Chief sink in water? Well, we would need to calculate the terminal velocity of Master Chief in armor with the presence of a buoyancy force. Turns out it's really not a simple equation. You need to find the square root of 4 times the gravity times the diameter of Master Chief sinking in a vertical pencil dive times the density of his armor minus the density of salt water divided by 3 times the drag coefficient of a human in a feet first pencil dive times salt water density. And finally, you get the terminal velocity of Master Chief in salt water, which is 8 meters per second. Or 26 feet per second. If you threw a standard cast iron dumbbell into the ocean, Master Chief would sink about twice as fast as that. Yep, he's fucked without us, and here's the real reason he's so fucked. And it's not him drowning, and it's not him being crushed by water pressure.